With me this morning from SigmaRoc, I'm very pleased to have Max Vermorken back in the studio. Max, good to see you. Good morning.
Good to see you too. Thank you very much for having us.
You've had your half-year results out this morning. Before we take a look at some of the numbers here, wouldn't hurt just to give us a quick recap about SigmaRoc itself. Just remind us what you're in the business of.
Good. So we're a construction materials group. We acquire, integrate, and improve construction materials companies, which basically produce aggregates, blocks, anything that has to do with heavy construction materials from a series of quarries we own, production yards we own across the UK and the Channel Islands.
Right, and so as you just said there, so the focus predominantly here for the UK?
Yeah. So far, yes. We've started as a cash shell in 2016, end of 16, beginning of 17, with the first acquisition, which was the Channel Islands one. Mm. And we've expanded across of this region first, because this is obviously where we started, and we have a good network of people here. The aim is obviously to go beyond the UK and go into Europe, Northern Europe, which is probably the next step.
Right. We'll talk a bit more about that in a moment. As far as the numbers are concerned, a full year, or at least a full 6 months contribution here from two acquisitions you made in December?
Correct.
Allen Concrete, Poundfield products?
Yeah. So we ended the year last year with two new acquisitions, Allen Concrete in October and Poundfield in December. Mm-hmm. Both were very good businesses. We liked them a lot. The contribution from these two companies last year was obviously negligible because they were brought into the company so late in the year. And our first 6 months of this year, we spend quite a lot of time to integrate them into what we now call our second platform. And the result of that is sales up by about 52% for the first 6 months versus the same period last year. EBITDA up by over 100%. And more interesting is we kept our capital structure effectively equal. So we did issue some shares, we issued some debt, but from a ratios perspective, it's the same. Yet our EPS has grown from 104 to 197. Mm-hmm. So I think the shareholders will be quite happy with that.
Tell me a little bit more about what you like about these two particular businesses.
So Allen Concrete is a well-known name in the fence post and fencing industry in and around the triangle, which is about between Ipswich, London, Wellingborough, sort of Northampton. They have a really nice positioning down there. Poundfield Products, based in Ipswich itself, sells much more into the infrastructure and farming and agricultural sectors. Mm. And that the two complement each other nicely, because now we have an exposure across housing, farming, infrastructure, across the works. Now, Poundfield is very interesting, and it's on its own because it owns 25 actually patents and trademarks on the different product groups it owns. So it's very unique business. I'm very happy with that.
And earlier last year, Rone's, of course, that was your first acquisition.
Yeah.
Remind us about this business.
So Rone is a construction materials group, an integrated business in the Channel Islands. Mm. It consists of effectively three companies now. Rone Jersey, which is the first island, Guernsey being the second one. And then we integrated a shipping business into that too, to be self-sufficient from a supply of cement and other materials. And that together formed our first platform, which is obviously successful so far. And we published the results in May. This year.
Are you up against much competition in the Channel Islands?
Competition structure is obviously a self-contained and small market. We have a competitor in Jersey, Granite Products, which is the other of the two quarries on the islands. Given the structure of the market, we are we're obviously required to offer a full service, a fully integrated business, which is what we have. So we do all services from the stone out of the ground, out of a quarry, all the way to paving driveways or airfields, and you name it.
I suppose it's a bit of a distant memory now, given the summer that we had. But the winter, back at the start of the year, it was harsher than many were expecting. I mean, did that impact you much?
It did impact us a little bit. So we had snowfall, and snowfall, if you have open yards where you produce products, tends to just shut down production. Delivery of truck material is not very easy when the roads are snowed over. So we did have a little bit of an impact there, primarily because the farming season started a bit later, and we sell quite a lot of product to the farming industry. Now we have seen a little bit of a catch up there, but as you can see from the results, we managed to navigate all that without too much trouble. So we're happy where we are.
And so, what are the plans for the second half?
Second half is where we're always busy in terms of finding the next targets. We've obviously got two platforms now. Complementing them with further acquisitions is target number one, and then looking for a third platform to start is the second idea we're looking at. So all of that's in the works, and as soon as we have some news on that, we'll come to you to talk to you about it.
Are you pretty close to another acquisition?
Yeah, we're always close. We have to be close because that's the fundamental driver of our business is to buy good businesses, integrate them into our structure, get the synergies going, yet keep the uniqueness of each company we buy because we don't want to destroy that given the very local nature of this industry, and then keep doing that.
And you'd be looking to find a business to complement the second platform, ideally.
Well, that's for sure one of the things that we would like to see because the second platform is quite nice, nicely positioned in terms of geography. It can expand across the UK because obviously it's now in the sort of southeast triangle there around London, Northampton, Ipswich. So there's obviously plenty of potential to take that business into the mainland of England and then maybe even further out. So that's for sure something that we're looking at. But then as soon as we have different product groups that we're looking at again, then we can take the third platform. The concept of building these platforms, bolting these businesses together, driving synergies, as you can see from the results, is clearly proven. And we've now got our team in place that is really efficient at doing that and delivering those results on very short order. Integration takes less than 6 months to get it properly done. And so we can use that machine that we've now actually built and deliver more results from it. And so that's really the key.
And so these two latest acquisitions, they're effectively pretty much fully integrated now, are they?
Yeah, well, the main focus of our integration is done.
Right.
And now it becomes a stage where we want to improve what we've got. So when we bought Poundfield, there were some safety concerns around the yard because it had become congested. There's too much product going on, too much movement of trucks and people. We had to segregate that, make sure that the business is well set up for further expansion. And that was part of our integration process, making sure that the two companies were hived into our structure without any disruption, customers not being thinking, well, what's going on here? All of that is key. We managed to get all of that done in the first 6 months, and now is delivering further synergies from them. So that's the next step.
So a strong first half. You're pretty confident you're on track to meet your full year expectations?
Yeah.
Right.
No problem there.
No issues. At the start, you talked about outside of Europe, outside of the UK, looking at Europe. How soon would you like to have a smallish footprint there to start with?
As soon as we can find something that we like at the right price. That's always the key. The key for us is buying something for the sake of buying it. That's never going to happen. It needs to be the right business at the right value. Our position in the UK is getting closer to where I would like to see it, to not be a tiny entity or just in the islands, which is what we were before. So with some further work, we will be in a good place there, and then it's obviously going to the mainland.
Well, what is a good place for you in the UK?
Well,
what's
bigger,
the ambition?
Bigger than we are now. The sky's the limit, but we can certainly be bigger than we are. We're only at 5 million EBITDA for the first half this year, close to. So there's plenty of... There's plenty to go at.
And well financed for the foreseeable future as well?
Yeah, I think so. Our debt facilities have plenty of capacity left, so I think we're cash generative, very cash generative, so I think we're fine.
Max, great to see you. Thanks for your time.
Much.